Okay, today is going to be a cool video. So I got this idea today from my Facebook page. People will often message me with suggestions. Somebody messaged me and said, "Hi, since we breathe in O2 and breathe out CO2, is it possible to carbonate a drink with just our breath?" So at first I thought, sure, theoretically, yes, you could carbonate a drink with your breath because you breathe out CO2, they carbonate drinks with CO2, so yes. But then I thought, wait, can you actually do it? How hard would it be to actually carbonate a drink with your breath? So today I'm going to be attempting to carbonate this Sprite with my own breath. So I let this Sprite sit out for about 2 days with the lid open, and it's completely decarbonated. There's no fizz in it whatsoever. You can see since there still is sugar in there, it still froths up when I shake it. But it does not build up pressure in the bottle when I shake it. So the soda is completely flat, no pressure in it. So there's a few problems I'm gonna need to be able to overcome in order to carbonate this drink. The first one is that I need high pressure in here. The higher pressure I can get in the headspace, the more carbonation there's gonna be, so the more fizz there'll be in the liquid. And the second obstacle is that I need to get as pure CO2 in the headspace as I can. So first of all, to try to get pure CO2 in here from your breath is gonna be difficult because number one, you breathe in air, and air is already only about 20% oxygen. The rest is nitrogen. And secondly, when you breathe in, you don't use up all of the oxygen in your breath. You only use a small portion of it. Most of the output when you breathe out is oxygen mixed with a little CO2. So I need to figure out a way to get pure oxygen to convert to CO2 and then completely convert it to CO2. So first I'm going to fill a bag with pure oxygen. Actually, it's only 95% oxygen. I had to laugh at this product. It's called Boost Oxygen. You can buy this at Walmart and a lot of different stores. It's just oxygen that you can breathe, I guess, to give you a boost if you need more oxygen. But this will work perfect for my experiment here. So I'll fill the bag with oxygen. And then I'm going to breathe in and out, breathe all the oxygen in the bag, and I'm going to cycle it a lot of times in and out, until eventually all of the oxygen will be converted into CO2. And then in my bag, I'm going to have a bike pump connected to my soda bottle, and I'm going to pressurize it with the bike pump. So it's going to be taking the CO2 that's in the bag, and I'll pressurize my soda bottle with it and see if I can actually recarbonate this drink with just my breath. So I haven't tried this before. I have no idea if it will work. The way I've thought to do it, it seems like it should work, but let's see. So the reason that I don't want any nitrogen in the headspace is because it will reduce the partial pressure of CO2 in the headspace. So for example, let's say I had a mixture of 80% nitrogen and 20% CO2 in here. If I were to pressurize that to 10 atmospheres, that means I'd have a partial pressure of 8 atmospheres of nitrogen and 2 atmospheres of CO2. And that's just the equivalent of pressurizing it to only 2 atmospheres of pure CO2. So it's very important to get the pure gas in there because then you don't get an equivalent reduced pressure due to other gases diluting the pressure inside. Okay, first let's fill our bag as much as I can with just pure oxygen. Now I'm going to be converting all this oxygen into CO2 and water. So I was breathing into a bag during this experiment, and not only is it dangerous because you're reducing the amount of oxygen that you're breathing, but also because breathing a lot of CO2, so when you just rebreathe the same air over and over again, the CO2 actually builds up in your blood, and it actually changes the pH of your blood. And your blood actually has to stay in a very tight range of pH. If it drops below or above a certain range, you can have a lot of side effects. I didn't want to put myself into acidosis, meaning the pH of my blood drops to a very low level due to the CO2 building up in my blood in the form of carbonic acid. So essentially it lowers the pH of my blood. And that's actually the same reason, like if you start hyperventilating, you get tingly fingers and stuff, That's because the hyperventilating is getting too much oxygen in your blood, so you lose some of the carbonic acid, so it makes the pH of your blood go up, and it makes you have symptoms such as tingly fingers and everything. That's because the pH of your blood changed because you are breathing too much oxygen too fast. Oh, okay. Running out of oxygen there. But I think I have a good amount of CO2 in there. I don't know how much that converted, but I definitely felt like there wasn't much oxygen left in there. Okay. Now, tie this off. There we go. We're at 40 PSI. Okay, now while it's pressurized in here, give it another shake to absorb all the CO2. Okay, I used up most of the CO2 in there, so I'm gonna do another round. Okay, let's open it up. See if we have some carbonated Sprite now. Whew, okay, that was a lot of work to carbonate this. Hopefully it worked. Okay, carbonated Sprite with my own breath. 3, 2, 1. Looks carbonated. Look at that. Look at all the bubbles coming out. Okay, let's give it a drink and see. It actually tastes a little bit carbonated. Look at that. Look at all the bubbles in there. I carbonated a Sprite with my own breath. So now that I let out the pressure, I can kind of check if there's some dissolved CO2 in here and see if it repressurizes the bottle. So once I release the pressure and then I shake it, the CO2 that was dissolved in the liquid at high pressure should undissolve out of the liquid and go back into the headspace and repressurize it if it actually did have CO2 in the liquid. So you can see how floppy the bottle is now, but if I shake it, see how firm it is? So it definitely has some CO2, a considerable amount of CO2 dissolved in the liquid. And you can hear when I open it, hear the pressure release. Here we go, listen. So you could hear the pressure release. That means the CO2 was dissolved in the liquid because it repressurized the bottle back up to its original partial pressure in the liquid. Okay, so there you go. Soda carbonated with my own breath. So why do we breathe out CO2? Well, when we metabolize our food, we're essentially doing the same thing that happens during combustion. We're taking the energy from long carbon chains, and instead of turning it into heat, we're turning it into movement and energy. And we also turn a little bit into heat. But the products of combustion are CO2 and water. And that's the same thing that we breathe out as CO2 and water. Although the pathway is different in order to get to the end products of CO2 and water, the overall chemical equation is the same. So you breathe out about 2.5 pounds of carbon dioxide every single day. So the fuel in your body isn't wood, it's actually sugars and fat. So when you burn fat or burn sugar, the mass doesn't just disappear, it has to go somewhere. And the primary excretion method for losing fat and sugars from your body is by breathing out. So the carbon atoms that used to be in the fat and the sugars in your body eventually leaves your body as the carbon and the carbon dioxide atoms. And this actually explains why you lose weight when you exercise, because the more you breathe out CO2, and that CO2 is actually taking the carbon atoms from your body and putting them in the air, so you lose weight. So for example, let's say I was 22 pounds overweight and I wanted to lose that weight. So I worked out really hard and I eventually lost those 22 pounds. Well, 18.5 of those pounds would have been lost from just the CO2 coming out of my breath. So why lose that hard-earned fat to the air when you can carbonate your own drinks with it? Hey everyone, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. That was a pretty good suggestion. I was really curious to see what would happen here. So if you're not subscribed yet, remember to hit the subscribe button, hit the bell to be notified when my latest videos out, and remember to leave me any questions in the comments section or any suggestions you have. I obviously get a lot of good suggestions from you guys. And as always, I'll see you next time.